हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास ऑफ प्लस वन स्टैंडर्ड. एज वी वर वर्किंग विद लेसन नंबर 10, रूरल डेवलपमेंट. इन दिस चैप्टर यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट, की इश्यूज इन रूरल डेवलपमेंट एंड रूरल क्रेडिट इन इंडिया, नीड फॉर क्रेडिट बाय फार्मर्स. नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द सोर्सेज ऑफ रूरल क्रेडिट इन इंडिया एंड क्रिटिकल अप्रेजल ऑफ रूरल बैंकिंग. After this, we will do the agriculture marketing, its meaning, defects of agriculture marketing in India, government measures for improving agricultural marketing, diversification of agriculture in India, its meaning, significance, agriculture diversification in India, organic farming, meaning of organic farming and benefits of organic farming. All these things we will discuss. Let us start with the topic. First of all, we will discuss rural areas. Students, you know that rural areas where there is a lack of facilities, like market facilities are far away from the residential areas, and no proper water supply are there, electricity supply it is not proper, even schooling it is not proper. So these kind of areas are known as rural areas, and these are also known as countrysides or villages in India. Like you know that there are number of villages are there: Boparai, Kathunangal, Ajnala, Verka, Gumtala, Mirakot, Balkala, Majitha, Chabal, Chogama, Kohali, and number of other villages are there which are known as the countrysides or villages. But according to the National Sample Survey Organization, that is NSSO, they defines the rural as the area with a population density of up to 400 per square kilometer and the villages with clear surveyed boundaries but no municipal board. So these villages have a very low population density, and according to the Reserve Bank of India, they define rural areas as those areas with a population of less than 49,000. According to the 2011 census, there were the total population in Amritsar district that was of 24,90,656, out of which 11,72,248 was the female population and 13,18,408 was the male population, and out of which 9,17,856 were workers, and 739 villages were there. A minimum of 75% of the male working population that was involved in agriculture and the allied activities. Allied activities like poultry it is there, fishery it is there, sheep rearing is there, horse rearing is there. These are the allied activities. In the rural areas, panchayat make the decisions like arrangement of street lights, drainage system, water supply, electricity supply, and even personal issues of the community, and the public distribution system, roads, all these things are watched by the panchayat. In panchayat there are 5 people and the main head is known as sarpanch. In rural areas, agriculture is the chief source of livelihood along with fishing, cottage industries, poultry, weavers are there, and even handlooms are there in the backyard also. In spite of all these, rural people have not done much to improve their production and standard of living, and they borrow from the money lenders in the villages to fulfill their needs and are exploited by the money lenders, mahajans, even traders and their relatives, as they charge high rate of interest from these innocent farmers. And moreover, these traders, mahajans and money lenders are not having proper record of lendings by these farmers. So to help and escape the village people from the hands of money lenders, mahajans, traders and from their relatives, and for the upliftment of these people, government has developed the thrift habits in the rural people बाय ओपनिंग द बैंक्स इन द रूरल एरियाज लाइक इन गुड़गांव ग्रामीण बैंक इज देयर, विदर्भ कोकण ग्रामीण बैंक इज देयर, त्रिपुरा ग्रामीण बैंक इट इज देयर. सो इन दीज रूरल एरियाज गवर्नमेंट हैज सेटअप द डिफरेंट बैंक्स सो दैट दे कैन एस्केप द विलेजर्स फ्रॉम द क्लचेज ऑफ द मनी लेंडर्स. एंड दीज बैंक्स ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड क्रेडिट फैसिलिटीज टू द फार्मर्स एट लो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स एंड फॉर द अपग्रेडेशन ऑफ लैंड, फॉर द परचेज ऑफ हाई यील्डिंग वराइटी सीड्स, फॉर द परचेज ऑफ इंसेक्टिसाइड्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स एंड फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट इट इज देयर. बैंक्स प्रोवाइड क्रेडिट फैसिलिटीज टू दीज फार्मर्स एट lower rate of interest. Let us discuss some key terms like bank, commercial bank, demand deposit. Bank. Students, you have seen number of banks like HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, State Bank of India, Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, Cooperative Bank, Prathama Bank, Punjab State, Cooperative Bank, बैंक ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, ओरिएंटल बैंक ऑफ कॉमर्स, कोटक महिंद्रा बैंक एंड मैनी अदर बैंक्स आर देयर. सो वट इज देयर इन दीज बैंक्स, दीज आर द फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस लाइसेंस टू रिसीव द डिपॉजिट्स एंड मेक लोन्स. दीज बैंक्स रिसीव द डिपॉजिट्स फ्रॉम द क्लाइंट्स एंड कॉमन पीपल set up their accounts like saving accounts in which they deposit their surplus money and the banks give the interest on these deposits. There are different kinds of deposits in these banks like fixed deposits are there, saving account is there, current account it is there, recurring deposit it is there. So banks may also provide financial services such as wealth management is there and currency exchange is there. Safe deposit boxes like lockers are there. So there are several different kinds of banks including retail banks, investment banks, commercial and corporate banks are there. First of all we will discuss commercial banks. State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, Allahabad Bank, Canara Bank, Bank of Baroda, HDFC Bank. All these are the examples of commercial banks of India. So commercial bank is a financial institution which accepts deposits from the public in their saving accounts, FD account and RDs. And on the behalf of these credits, they give loans for the purpose of consumption and investment. Like people take the demand loans for the house loan also and study loan also. So on the behalf of these deposit, commercial bank advances loans to the customers. Commercial banks are also called the joint stock banks. Joint stock banks means investors purchase the shares of these banks with the help of open market operations. Open market operation, we mean that sale and purchase of the securities. For example, the government has recently purchased the shares of Punjab National Bank after the merging of Oriental Bank of Commerce and Punjab National Bank. So, commercial banks provide short-term loans to the businessmen and traders also. Demand deposits. Students, demand deposits like saving deposit it is there and current deposit it's there. Saving deposits are by the common people. And the current account it is maintained by the businessman. On the saving account, common people deposit their surplus anytime and can withdraw also money from their account anytime without any prior information to the bank. And banks also provide interest on these deposits. On the other hand, current deposits that is by the businessman. And on these accounts, the bank will not provide any interest to the businessman. Rather, businessman gives some money to the banks for the rendering their services. So, demand deposit is on demand, allowing anyone dealing with a bank or financial institution to withdraw funds without previous notice. डिमांड डिपॉजिट टाइप्स आर चेकिंग अकाउंट, सेविंग अकाउंट, टर्म डिपॉजिट्स लाइक फिक्स डिपॉजिट्स एंड रेकरिंग डिपॉजिट्स एंड मनी मार्केट अकाउंट्स. टिल 1970 कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स लाइक हरियाणा स्टेट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, महाराष्ट्र स्टेट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, बिहार स्टेट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, प्रथमा बैंक, दीज बैंक्स वर द मेजर सोर्स ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशनल क्रेडिट इन रूरल एरियाज. एंड इट इज सीन दैट ओनली कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स कैन नॉट फुलफिल द ग्रोइंग नीड्स ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल क्रेडिट. टू ओवरकम द डिफेक्ट्स ऑफ द कोऑपरेटिव बैंकिंग, द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज अडॉप्टेड द सोशल बैंकिंग एंड मल्टीपल एजेंसी अप्रोच टू मीट द नीड्स ऑफ रूरल क्रेडिट एडिक्वेटली. सोशल बैंकिंग वी मीन दैट वैन वी डाउनलोड अ बैंक्स मोबाइल ऐप टू क्रिएट एन अकाउंट बाय टेकिंग अ सेल्फी एंड एंटर फ्यू रेलिवेंट डिटेल्स इंक्लूडिंग द कस्टमर्स नेशनल आइडेंटिटी लाइक आधार कार्ड इंफॉर्मेशन टू क्रिएट अ बैंक अकाउंट इन फ्यू मिनट्स. यू नो दैट ई बैंकिंग इट इज देयर एंड बैंकिंग गोज डिजिटल एंड पे ऑन एनी टाइम एनी वेयर. लाइक दिस वन सोशल बैंकिंग इट इज देयर, गूगल पे इट इज देयर, नंबर ऑफ अदर सोशल बैंकिंग इट इज देयर. एंड वी कैन पे यूटिलिटी बिल्स थ्रू फेसबुक मैसेंजर, मीट बैंक एम्प्लॉयज वर्चुअली थ्रू वीडियो ब्रांच सर्विसेज एंड फॉलो अ बैंक्स ट्विटर अकाउंट टू पे अ फ्रेंड और टू द रिलेटिव्स और टू पेरेंट्स और टू योर ब्रदर और सिस्टर एंड इंटरेक्ट विद अ रोबोट एट द बैंक ब्रांच रिगार्डिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन बैंकिंग ट्रांजेक्शन्स ऑल्सो. सो मल्टीपल एजेंसी अप्रोच टू मीट द नीड्स ऑफ द रूरल क्रेडिट एडिक्वेटली, इंडिया हैज ऑप्टेड फॉर मल्टी एजेंसी सिस्टम ऑफ रूरल बैंकिंग बिकॉज एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर मेनली डिपेंड्स ऑन द क्रेडिट इनपुट्स दीज डेज. इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द कॉम्पिटिशन अमंग्स द कॉमर्शियल बैंक्स इन रूरल एरियाज, अ पॉलिसी ऑफ सर्विस एरिया अप्रोच हैज बीन अडॉप्टेड सिंस 1988. कॉमर्शियल बैंक्स हैव नाउ द राइट टू गिव एग्रीकल्चर फाइनेंस. देर आर नंबर ऑफ कॉमर्शियल बैंक्स विच आर नेशनलाइज्ड. अ लिस्ट ऑफ दीज नेशनलाइज्ड कॉमर्शियल बैंक इट इज आंध्रा बैंक, बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, अलाहाबाद बैंक, बैंक ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, सेंट्रल बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, देना बैंक, इंडियन बैंक, इंडियन ओवरसीज बैंक, ओरिएंटल बैंक ऑफ कॉमर्स, सिंडिकेट बैंक, यूको बैंक, यूनाइटेड बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, विजया बैंक, पंजाब नेशनल बैंक, बैंक ऑफ बड़ौदा, कैनरा बैंक, यूनियन बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एंड पंजाब एंड सिंध बैंक. स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया दैट इज नॉट इंक्लूडेड इन द लिस्ट ऑफ द नेशनलाइज्ड बैंक्स बिकॉज इट वॉज ऑलरेडी अ स्टेट ओन्ड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन इन द कंट्री. द शेयर ऑफ द कॉमर्शियल बैंक इन प्रोवाइडिंग एग्रीकल्चर क्रेडिट वॉज नेग्लिजिबल. आफ्टर द नेशनलाइजेशन दीज बैंक्स हैव ओपन्ड अ नंबर ऑफ ब्रांचेज इन रूरल एरियाज. फर्स्टली द रीजन वॉज फॉर द नेग्लिजिबल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर बाय द कॉमर्शियल बैंक वॉज दैट कॉमर्शियल बैंक्स वर रिलक्टेंट टू गिव लोन्स टू द फार्मर्स बिकॉज दे वर फार्मर्स वर इलिटरेट एंड दे कुड नॉट कम्प्लीट द पेपर वर्क एंड हैंस इट वॉज रिस्की टू गिव लोन्स टू द फार्मर्स. एंड द अनदर रीजन इज दैट द मानसून कंडीशंस, इफ देयर इज अ अनफेवरेबल मानसून देन ऑल्सो द फार्मर्स आर अनएबल टू रिटर्न द लोन्स टू द कॉमर्शियल बैंक्स. सो आफ्टर द प्लानिंग पीरियड some changes are there due to the different programs, agricultural programs like irrigation facilities are there and modern techniques of cultivation, and the government provided loans to the farmers for the upgradation of land also. So regional rural banks are set up in the rural areas. Their objective is to fulfill the credit needs of poor farmers. Loans are given for productive purposes like irrigation facilities, power it is there, development of land, purchasing of seeds, high yielding variety seeds, purchase of fertilizers, insecticides. For all these banks provide loans to the farmers. Commercial banks provide loans both directly to the farmers and indirectly to the other agencies. Other agencies, we mean to say that cooperative societies who finance farmers, consumer cooperative society, producer cooperative society, cooperative credit societies are there, marketing cooperative society is there, housing cooperative society, cooperative farming societies are there. So there are different types of cooperative societies. First one is consumer cooperative society. It is to protect the interest of the general consumer by making consumer goods available at a reasonable prices. These societies purchase the things from the producers and they sell it in the market at a reasonable prices. And next cooperative society, that is producers cooperative society, that is to set up to protect the interest of the small producers by making available items of their need for production, like raw material. If mattress business it is there, then they provide the sponge and raw material to these producers, and even tools and equipments, machinery, all these things are provided by these cooperative societies. Examples for these producers cooperative society, like Bayanka it is there, Haryana Handloom is there. All these are the examples of producers cooperative society. Next, cooperative market society, that is these societies are formed by the small producers and manufacturers who find it difficult to sell their products individually, like Amul it is there. This is the best example for the cooperative marketing society. Next, the types of cooperative society examples are there. Consumer cooperative society, like Kendriya Bhandar in Delhi, Alaka in Bhubaneswar, and producers cooperative example, that is Handloom Owner cooperatives are there, Haryana cooperatives are there, and marketing cooperatives like Kashmir Art Emporium, J&K Handicrafts are there, and credit cooperatives like Urban Cooperative Bank it is there. So consumer cooperatives, under the consumers cooperatives, they meet their common needs and aspirations. They can use the services like home delivery and store it is there, insurance, welfare and nursery care, all these services that can be used by the consumer cooperatives. And the operations, like members have their say at general assemblies and committee, and voluntary activities also there. Another cooperative societies like Shriram Mutually Aided Consumer Cooperative Society Limited, Hyderabad, and the Swastik Consumer Cooperative Store Limited, Gadwal Cooperative Sales, Uttaranchal Pradesh, and Producers Cooperative Society, that is to protect the interest of small producers like weavers, artisans, and stitching by making available raw materials, tools and equipments, machinery, etc., like for the producers of the carpets, arranging marketing and distribution channels. Examples for the producers cooperative societies like Amul it is there. Amul is the best example. APCO, Bayanka, Haryana Handloom, all these are the examples of producers cooperative society. Another cooperative societies are National Fisherman Products Cooperative Society Limited, Seafood Market it is there. So cooperative market society, a society of small producers and manufacturers, like carpeting business it is there, and cottage industries is there, handloom industries are there, power looms are there. So these producers, these cooperative societies collects the products from the members of the society and make available better marketing and distribution channels economically and sells in the market at a reasonable prices. And the best example, you know that Anand Milk Union Limited, that is Amul, UP Handloom is there. Another examples for the cooperative societies, that is Annapurna Mahila Credit Cooperative Society, Krishak Bharti Cooperative Limited, that is CRIBCO, and many other cooperative societies are there in Delhi also. So commercial banks provide the credit facilities to these cooperative societies, and the cooperative societies purchase the things or the produce from the small producers and give them some advance to these producers and the farmers also, so that they can continue with their business. And when they sell their produce in the market at a reasonable prices, these cooperative societies help the farmers and the small producers also. Commercial banks have been directed to advance 40% of their loans to the priority sector. Like agriculture form a part of the priority sector. The priority sector like agriculture is there, micro enterprises are there, and weaker section. These are the priority sectors for the commercial bank. Their share in institutional credit to agriculture increased from 38.4% in 1980 till 81 to 71.2% in 2012 till 13. So as a result, what happened, the share of cooperative banks declined from 61.6% to 18.3% during the same period. Now we will discuss the features of the commercial banks. Commercial banks deal with money. Commercial banks accept deposits from the common public and businessmen also. And on the behalf of these credits, they advances the short-term loans. And people also take the loans from the commercial banks, like house loan it is there, study loan it is there. So its aim is to earn profit. This is the main goal of the commercial bank, to earn the profit. Commercial banks create credit by accepting the deposits in the form of saving account, fixed deposits and recurring deposits. Commercial banks create demand deposits like saving account and current account. Saving account it is for the household sector, and current account it is for the business sector. On the saving account, bank gives rate of interest, and on the current account, businessmen give the some amount of money to the banks. So commercial banks create demand deposits which serve as a medium of exchange. Commercial banks deal with the general public for the acceptance of the deposits and for advancing loans also. Demand deposits, you know that there are saving deposits and current deposits. Saving deposits from the household sector and current deposit by the business sector. There are another types of demand deposits, that is checking accounts, savings, term deposits like fixed deposits and recurring deposits. And these deposits, fixed deposit and recurring deposits, we can withdraw money on the date of maturity only. And under the saving deposit, we can deposit and withdraw money any time from the bank without any prior information to the banks. And next type of the demand deposit, it is money market account. So demand deposit is on demand, allowing anyone dealing with the bank or financial institution to withdraw funds without previous notice. Now we will discuss regional rural banks, RRBs, RRBS. Andhra Pragati Grameen Bank, Arunachal Pradesh Rural Bank, Assam Grameen Vikas Bank, Bangya Grameen Vikas Bank, Kaveri Grameen Bank, Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank, all these are the names of the regional rural banks. So these banks get their top management from the nationalized banks like Bank of Allahabad, Canara Bank, Oriental Bank of Commerce. So the headquarter of regional rural bank is at New Delhi, and the largest regional rural bank in India is Syndicate Bank. The three regional rural banks promoted by the सिंडिकेट बैंक दैट इज प्रथमा बैंक, कर्नाटका विकास ग्रामीण बैंक, आंध्र प्रगति ग्रामीण बैंक. सो दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ द थ्री रीजनल रूरल बैंक्स दैट इज प्रमोटेड बाय द सिंडिकेट बैंक. विद अ व्यू टू सप्लीमेंट द एफर्ट्स ऑफ द कॉमर्शियल बैंक्स एंड कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स इन प्रोवाइडिंग रूरल क्रेडिट, रीजनल रूरल बैंक्स वर सेटअप. दीज बैंक्स आर यूजली सेटअप इन दोज रूरल एरियाज विच हैव द पोटेंशियल ऑफ डिस्प्लेइंग अ हाई रेट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर ग्रोथ इन फ्यूचर, बट वेयर करंटली देयर इज नो बैंक्स और अदर सोर्सेज ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशनल क्रेडिट एंड द फार्मर्स ओनली डिपेंडेंट ऑन द मर्सी ऑफ द मनी लेंडर्स एंड महाजन्स, ट्रेडर्स एंड इवन देयर रिच रिलेटिव्स. देयर मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू मीट द क्रेडिट नीड्स ऑफ स्मॉल एंड मार्जिनल फार्मर्स एंड लैंडलेस वर्कर्स. हाउएवर द लोन्स आर गिवन ओनली फॉर द प्रोडक्टिव पर्पजेस. प्रोडक्टिव पर्पजेस लाइक परचेज ऑफ लैंड एंड अपग्रेडेशन ऑफ लैंड, परचेज ऑफ सीड्स and irrigation facilities, set up small businesses like carpeting, cottage industry in their backyards. So government and the institutional credit facilities are provided for the productive purposes. Initially, five regional rural banks were set up in 1975, whose number later on rose to 196 in 2005. But afterwards, their number declined under the amalgamation, that is join up of the banks process that is initiated by the government. So these regional rural banks are operated at district level with local staff only. Policy on the agriculture credit aims at progressive institutionalization of credit agencies for providing credit to farmers for raising agriculture production and productivity. For this, the government has taken number of steps, like government has started the Kisan credit card scheme also, and government also give the gold loan also, and provide the credit facilities to the poor farmers at a cheaper rate of interest. The flow of institutional credit for agriculture and allied activities like poultry, dairy farming, sheep rearing, which was ₹69,560 crore in 2002 till 2003, and that has been increased to ₹607,375 crore in 2012 till 13. So our government has decided to provide 2% subsidy to public sector banks and regional rural banks to ensure availability of farm loans at 7% interest rate. Now the different sources of institutional credit in 2012 and 13 were cooperative banks, commercial banks and regional rural banks. Now we will discuss about the National Bank for Agriculture Rural Development, that is NABARD. So let us understand the meaning of NABARD and what is the purpose of NABARD. The most important development in the field of rural credit is the setting up of NABARD in July 1982 as an apex body to coordinate the activities of all institutions involved in rural finance. NABARD provided refinance facility to state cooperative banks and commercial banks and regional rural banks, which in turn provide credit to the farmers. Under the NABARD, there is a new hope for the farmers and artisans, like joint liability groups. Under the joint liability groups, these are run by the banks and non-government organizations, and farmer clubs are there. And the advantages of joint liability group is the collateral free credit to the tenant farmers. And the government also started the Kisan credit card scheme, that is the scheme of Krishi Jagran. farmers produce organization operations has been started, like input centers are there and loan repayment system it is there. Farm equipment, that is tractors, trolleys, combines, threshers, and produce agrarian, it is there. Warehousing for storage, and milk agrarian, aggregation and sale, it is there. Under the National Bank for Agriculture, Rural Development, that is NABARD, also directs, inspect and supervises the credit flows for agriculture and rural development. NABARD also help the non-farm sectors. Non-farm sectors like artisans are there, weavers are there, small cottage industries are there, and village industries are there, and a number of other things like carpeting, it is there. So NABARD does not deal with the farmers and the rural people directly. NABARD grants assistance to the cooperative banks, commercial banks and regional rural banks, which give credit further to the rural people. Like NABARD, under NABARD scheme, dairy loan it is there, and NABARD subsidies on dairy it is there by the State Bank of India, easy dairy loan from the Punjab National Bank. In the same way, in the interim budget 2019-20, there is a scheme for the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi Yojana, it is there, under which direct income support for ₹6,000 per annum for the farmers, and that has been effective from the date of 1st December 2018. And to this scheme has benefited to 12 crore small and marginal farmers, families and having cultivable land up to 2 hectare. Now next one is the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Government of India, that is Farmer Producer Organizations, FPOs. 383 Farmer Producer Organizations have been registered during 2014-17, as compared to 223 Farmer Producer Organizations during 2011-14, with total increase of 71.74% towards collectivization of farmers. In the union budget, again coming union budget, that is the budget of 2020-21, agriculture, irrigation and rural development programs are there, and under which there is a target of 20 lakh farmers to be covered for the stand alone solar pumps under the Prime Minister Kusum Yojana, and doubling milk processing capacity by 2025. Integration of ENWR and ENAM, Kisan Rail and Kisan Udan, and 15 lakh rupees crore for the agriculture credit target, it is there, and self-help groups, run village storage schemes, all these are the schemes for the next budget. Jan Jan Ka budget, under which the government has given the facilities to the farmers for rupees 2.83 lakh crore allocated for agriculture sector. PM Kusum launched to cover 20 lakh farmers for solar pumps and further 15 lakh for grid connected pumps. Kisan Rail to be set up by Indian Railways, and a Krishi Udan scheme to be launched by the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Under the Union Budget 2020-21, what is here? That is receipts of 2020-21. Estimated at 22.46 lakh crore rupees and expenditure at 30.42 lakh crore rupees. Further fiscal deficit of 3.8% in revenue expenditure in 2019-20 and 3.5% in budget expenditure, that is 2020-21. The functions of NABARD, that is National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. NABARD acts as an apex body to look after the credit requirements of rural sector. Rural sector like villages are there, or the countrysides where there is a lack of facilities of not having a safe drinking water, electricity supply it is not proper, and the farmers are illiterate, and schooling it is not up to the mark. So NABARD supervises the functioning of the cooperative sectors also. Cooperative sectors like producer cooperative societies are there, which purchase the things from the producers, small producers, and sell it in the market and provide some credit in advance to these producers and farmers also. NABARD provides short-term credit to the state cooperative and banks for seasonal agriculture operations, like agriculture operations like marketing of crops and purchase of fertilizers and insecticides, etc. Next one is the under the functions of NABARD also provide medium term credit to state cooperative banks and regional rural banks for specific agricultural purposes like restoration of land productivity in areas that is affected by the natural calamities. NABARD also administer a research and development fund to promote the research work. Here the word natural calamities like floods are there, famines are there. Recently you can see the flood conditions in Bihar. Then there is a three-tier system, that is state cooperative banks, state cooperative agriculture and rural development bank, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, district cooperative banks, primary agricultural credit societies, district central cooperative bank, primary cooperative agriculture and rural development banks are there. Now we will discuss the Kisan Credit Scheme. Under the KCC, that is Kisan Credit Scheme, it was introduced in 1988 for short-term and medium-term loans. The features of this Kisan Credit Scheme, that is farmers eligible for the production credit of rupees 5000 or more are eligible for issue of Kisan Credit Card. Eligible farmers to be provided with the KCC and passbook or card cum passbook. Provision of revolving cash credit facility involving any number of draws and repayment within limits. Entire production credit needs for full year plus ancillary activities related to the crop production considered while fixing this limit. In due course, all activities and non-farm credit needs may also be covered. Non-farm credit needs like dairy it is there, small scale manufacturing, shopkeepers are there. So limit to be fixed on the basis of the operational land holdings, like limit of land holdings that is of 2 hectare and a cropping pattern and the scale of finance. Sub limits may be fixed at discretion of banks and card valid for 3 years subject to the annual review and each drawal to be repaid within 12 months. These were the norms with this Kisan Credit Card. Conversion and reschedulement of loans also permissible in case of damage to crops and due to natural calamities like floods, famines and drought conditions. As incentives for the good performance, credit limits could be enhanced to take care of increase in costs, change in the cropping pattern, and security margin rate of interest as per the Reserve Bank of India norms. Operations may be through issuing branch or at the discretion of bank through other designated branches. Withdrawals through slips, checks accompanied by card and passbook are there. Now we will discuss the reason behind the Kisan Credit Card Scheme. There were several reasons. As you know that there are several hurdles that is faced by the farmers in the process of acquiring adequate finance from banks, such as long drawn out documentation and processing, complicated practices followed by banks, delay in processing, and also lack of awareness among the farmers regarding the banking process. farmers also hesitate to go to the banks due to lengthy formalities of paperwork, and most farmers depend on the non-institutional means of credit for their immediate needs. Like, they depend upon the money lenders, Mahajans, who can immediately provide them credit, and they can have a purchase of seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, and this in turn affects them negatively, since non-institutional credit is costly and counterproductive also. Microfinance company. There are number of microfinance companies in India, like Annapurna Microfinance Private Limited, Arohan Financial Services Private Limited, which play some pivotal roles to the development of India. India's microfinance sector is fragmented with more than 3,000 microfinance companies and non-government organizations like Ujjivan it is there and Sadhan it is there. Another names of the microfinance companies like Annapurna Microfinance Private Limited, Arohan Financial Services Private Limited, Ashirvad Microfinance Private Limited, Bandhan Financial Services Private Limited, BSS Microfinance Private Limited, Cashpoor Microcredit, Disha Microfinance Private Limited, Equitas Microfinance Private Limited. All these are the microfinance companies in India. So the microfinance companies and microfinance schemes, out of which the self-help group bank linkage program is the major microfinance program. Under this program, 563 districts in all the states and union territories have been covered. 560 banks, including 48 commercial banks and 196 regional rural banks and 316 cooperative banks, along with 3,024 non-government organizations, are now associated with this program. That is a program of self-help group. Under this program, there are different states are there, like Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Punjab, Uttarakhand, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim, Tripura, and Union Territories also involved: Andaman, Nicobar, Goa, Ladakh, Lakshadweep, Puducherry, Dadar and Nagar Haveli, and Daman and Diu. So under the self-help group, that is a microfinance scheme, promote the thrift habits, means saving habits among the rural households. Mostly the rural households having unnecessary habits of expenditure on the marriage ceremonies or on the rituals. So small savings are mobilized by the self-help groups and offered as a credit to its different members, depending on their needs. If the needs are productive or for the investment purposes, these self-help groups, that is microfinance schemes, help the rural people. And the credit is offered without any security, without any mortgage, and at a very low rate of interest. The focus under the self-help group bank linkage program is largely on those rural poor who have no sustainable access to the formal banking system. Let us discuss the advantages of a microfinance scheme. First one is a timely repayment of loans to the banks and reduction in the transaction costs involved in taking and providing loans at doorsteps. Saving and credit facilities to the poor and exploitation of untapped, means untouched, business potentials of the rural areas. So these involve small account of loans to the self-help groups without any collaterals, means securities, for undertaking self-employment projects. Self-employment projects like weavers are there, artisans are there. In this way, there is a self-employment, it is there, like cobblers are also there, shoemaking shops are there. सो प्रोविजन इवेल्युएशन ऑफ द रूरल क्रेडिट सिस्टम, प्रोविजन ऑफ क्रेडिट फॉर प्रोडक्टिव पर्पजेज ऑन इजी टर्म्स, मोबिलाइजेशन ऑफ रूरल सेविंग्स एंड यूज इट फॉर रेजिंग द एग्रीकल्चरल इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑल्सो, एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन इन द रूरल एरियाज लाइक अंडर द स्कीम ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टर एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन प्रोग्राम गेट अ लोन विथ सब्सिडी. नेक्स्ट इज अ प्राइम मिनिस्टर एम्प्लॉयमेंट गारंटी जनरेशन प्रोग्राम्स आर देयर, नेशनल रूरल एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन स्कीम्स आर देयर, माइक्रो स्मॉल एंड मिनी एंटरप्रेन्योर्स आर ऑल्सो देयर. सो इवेल्यूएशन ऑफ द रूरल क्रेडिट सिस्टम, एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट, एनर्जेटिक एंटरप्रेन्योर्स हु आर अनेबल टू अंडरटेक एनी न्यू वेंचर और बिजनेस ड्यू टू द पॉसिटी मीन स्केसिटी ऑफ फाइनेंस. सो दीज बैंक्स मे एनक्वायर इन टू द फ्यूचर पॉसिबिलिटीज ऑफ दीज बिजनेस एंड गिव नेसेसरी ट्रेनिंग टू दीज एंटरप्रेन्योर्स एंड सप्लाई देम फाइनेंस टू मेक देयर बिजनेस सक्सेसफुल. इवेल्यूएशन ऑफ द रूरल क्रेडिट सिस्टम, रूरल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट दैट इज मनरेगा, महात्मा गांधी नेशनल रूरल एम्प्लॉयमेंट गारंटी एक्ट, प्रधानमंत्री ग्राम सड़क योजना, नेशनल रूरल लाइवलीहुड्स मिशन NRLM, इंदिरा आवास योजना, टोटल सैनिटेशन कैंपेन एंड मैनी अदर स्कीम्स आर ऑल्सो देयर दैट इज जनरेटेड बाई द लाइक जवाहर रोजगार योजना इट इज देयर, नेहरू आवास योजना इज देयर एंड कंटेनिंग द इंसिडेंस ऑफ रूरल पॉवर्टी एंड इन रूरल पॉवर्टी एलिवेशन प्रोग्राम्स आर ऑल्सो देयर. पॉवर्टी एलिवेशन प्रोग्राम्स दैट इज ऑल्सो जनरेटेड बाई द गवर्नमेंट लाइक 100 डेज रोजगार योजना इट इज देयर, जवाहर रोजगार योजना इट इज देयर, मनरेगा योजना इट इज देयर. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस सम वीकनेसेस ऑफ द रूरल क्रेडिट प्रोग्राम. फर्स्ट वीकनेस दैट इज द फॉलिंग शेयर ऑफ द रूरल क्रेडिट. In spite of the setting up of the commercial banks and the regional rural banks in the rural areas, still people are reluctant or hesitate to go to the banks because of the lengthy paperwork and formalities are there, and they prefer to go to the money lenders or to the traders or to the relatives for the fulfillment of their credit needs. And moreover, the commercial banks also failure to give the maximum credit due to the debt burden, because number of poor people are reluctant to take the loans from these banks. That's why they don't want to go to the banks for the credit facilities, for the financial credits. So what happened with this? Commercial banks are not following the rules as the in the papers it is written that guarantee or the security it is not demanded while giving loans to the farmers. But in spite of that, cooperatives and the commercial banks asking mortgage or the guarantee or the securities while giving loans to the poor farmers. And what happened as a result, there is a limited lending to the weaker sections, so falling share of the rural credit. Next one is growing number of willful defaulters among the borrowers. What happened? Sometimes some people are able to return the loans, but they are reluctant to return the loans. They are known as the willful defaulters. There is a list of the willful defaulters, out of which there are the few names like Gitanjali at Gems Limited and ReAgro Limited and Winsome Diamonds and Jewelry Limited. These are the names of the willful defaulters. So next one is the inadequate coverage of microfinance programs like stitching activities, small kiosk centers like Kirana store is there, eggs and egg store it is there, papad store. All these are known as kiosk centers. So hope students you all have understood the topic of the rural credit. Now it's time to note down the homework. Our first question is define the following terms with examples: cooperative banks, commercial banks, rural areas and NABARD. Question number 2 is, what is the importance of the rural development in the Indian economy? Give two arguments. Question number 3 is, what kind of credit do Indian farmers need and why? Question number 4 is, when was the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development established? Why was it set up? Question number 5 is, critically evaluate the role of rural development in India. Question number 6 is, write a note on self-help group. Question number 7 is, write the advantages of microfinance scheme. Question number 8 is, write the features of Kisan Credit Card, that is KCC. Question number 9 is, define traders. Question number 10 is, what do you know about credit facilities? Question number 11, at what time do farmers need credit facilities? And why do the poor farmers prefer to take loans from moneylenders and not from commercial banks? Question number 13 is, name the institutional sources of finance. Question number 14 is the loan taken from the moneylenders beneficial for the poor farmers? If no, then why? Question number 15 is, discuss the ways in which the farmers deprive due to inadequate credit facilities. Question number 16 is, discuss the features of commercial bank. And students, please go through the YouTube links also for more clarity of the topic, and hope you all will complete your homework in your fair copy for better learning also. And students, thank you for listening.